Morning, class A students. Today we will continue with chemical properties of metals and non-metals. In the last class, we have read about physical properties of metals and non-metals. We have seen how they are different from each other in different physical properties, like physical state, color, luster, right, density, sonority. Okay, now we will see how metals and non-metals show different chemical properties. Metals are very reactive elements. They usually react fast. So we will start with reaction of metals and non-metals with oxygen first. We will start with sodium. Sodium react with oxygen at room temperature and produces oxide, that is sodium oxide. Sodium oxide formula NH2O. Sodium react with oxygen at room temperature produces sodium oxide. So we will balance like this. Next, it is magnesium. Magnesium do not react with oxygen at room temperature. It reacts with oxygen under heat. So if heated, then magnesium will produce magnesium oxide. Next example with zinc. So like sodium react with oxygen in at room temperature, but magnesium, zinc, iron, they do not react at room temperature. Zinc upon strong heating forms zinc oxide. Iron also upon strong heating produce iron oxide. So zinc, that is Zn plus oxygen, under strong heating produces zinc oxide. Now metals reacting with oxygen and produce metallic oxides. These are basic oxides. Metallic oxides are basic oxides, right? Next, it is reaction of non-metals with oxygen. First, we will start with carbon. Carbon react with oxygen and produces carbon dioxide. Carbon burns in the presence of oxygen to form carbon dioxide. Now this non-metallic oxide, when dissolved in water, non-metallic oxides when dissolved in water produces basic oxides. We will see how carbon dioxide when dissolved in water produces carbonic acid, that is H2CO3. Next example, sulfur. Sulfur burns in the presence of oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide, when dissolved in water, produces sulfurous acid. Produces sulfurous acid. metals like sodium and potassium react vigorously with oxygen at room temperature to form sodium oxide and potassium oxide respectively. Since these metals burst into flames if left in the open, that is in air, they are hence stored by keeping them immersed in kerosene. So metals like sodium and potassium are stored by keeping them immersed in kerosene. Okay, now we will see how metals react with water. Reaction of metals with water. For example, sodium react with water, normal water at room temperature, and produces NaOH. So metals reacting with water produces either metallic oxides or metallic hydroxides, and hydrogen gas is released in this process. So sodium react with water, cold water, to form sodium hydroxide, and hydrogen gas is released. So here you write sodium hydroxide and this reaction releases hydrogen gas. So metals when react with water releases hydrogen gas, whereas metals like magnesium and zinc do not react with cold water, they react with hot water or steam. Magnesium react with steam, produces magnesium oxide, and hydrogen gas is released. Zinc react with steam, produces zinc water, zinc oxide, and hydrogen gas is released in this process. So metals react with water to form either metallic oxides or metallic hydroxides. Now we will see how non-metals react with water. But before that, metals like aluminium do not react with water. It's because aluminium, as it is exposed to air, it produces a layer of aluminium oxide. Therefore, it do not react with water further. And metals like gold, silver, platinum are very less reactive. Non-metals, reaction with water, there is no reaction, because under any condition, non-metals do not react with water. Non-metals do not react with water. So, mostly sodium and potassium are most reactive. Therefore, they react with water under room temperature, which is cold water. But zinc, magnesium, iron do not react with cold water. They react with steam. Non-metals do not react with water under any condition.